You sit down and you think about it. You couldn't dream up anything more crazy or dangerous.
Man against beast. Man with our fragile body against pure strength and fury.
He is bigger, tougher, stronger than you, and so therefore you've got to find an edge. We find the center of gravity and we find where there is no power.
He's just so strong and so quick. He just gets around there so hard and has so much whip and speed to him that all the G-force is all pulling you to the outside.
That bull just really loved the game. He probably ran over 85 or 90% of the guys that ever faced him. As they get bucked more and more, they get smart.
From Tomah, Wisconsin, this is Fred Betcher, Ross Johnson, Matt Bohan, Canada's BJ Cramps, the wild man Tony Mendes.
And now it's time to meet the ones that have risen above the rest. Let's meet them right now. Elkton, Oklahoma's Justin McBride. He comes to us from Paradise, Texas. This is Mike Lee. From Sao Paulo, Brazil, the one and only, the number one man, Adriano Moraes. Some noise.
Only the blood into the English, but the new grass from evil.
2003, I didn't write good at all. I barely qualified to the finals. I really thought my riding ability was gone and I would never be a good rider again. And just overnight, I started riding good again, and here I am leading with a chance to do what nobody else has ever done, to win title three times. Every time that I'm riding good, I am closer to my God. And every time that I'm not riding good, I'm not close to Him. When in other heads, we feel so alone. Right when that gate cracks open, man, God help us, because we have nothing to hold on to but that rope. And we have to rely on something that's greater, something that's stronger than we are. And we rely on God for protection, we rely on Him for strength and for knowledge, knowledge of how to ride bulls.
We ask for strength. We are weak, but thou art strong. Lord, strengthen this body. If there be any weakness in our body, touch us from the crown of our head to the soles of our feet. Lord, we thank you that you're here. And Father, we'll give you the praise, the honor, and the glory for what you're doing in our lives. Amen. Take them. Take them in Jesus' name.
Are you ready to ride some bulls with a PBR on a Saturday night?
One of the great adrenaline sports. You've got a strong, tough cowboy sitting on top of a 2,000-pound bull with his sole objective to ride for 8 seconds. If he does that by keeping one free hand up in the air and not touching the bull, he's scored up to 50 points on how stylish and how well he can ride the bull. Now, the bull also gets points up to 50 for how strong and how hard he bucks. Bulls are really given a lot of points if they spin, if they kick high, and what they do to try to throw that cowboy off their back. The cowboy who has the most points at the end of the night walks away the victor.
We are just modern day gladiators. It's a crowd, an arena, a beast, and a man. Possibility of getting hurt, blood, and death. So every time that we do good, people love it. Every time that the bull does good, they love it too. So the crowd always wins.
Adriano Moraes, this is the man they're all chasing. Two world championships already in his pocket and now reaching down deep to go for a third.
When you look at Adriano, I think he's got the riding style that gives him the best advantage to win. He keeps his upper body forward, and you don't see him getting leaned back, out of control, stretched out on the end of his arm.
It amazes me the fact that people can't see the athletic ability that it takes to do this sport. Well, I've heard 8 million times, what do you do, just hold on for dear life? You know, and that always just stuns me. It requires agility and balance and strength and flexibility and reaction time. But on top of that, it takes a lot of hard work and a lot of dedication.
Now here's another big name, and right now he's in the number two position, right behind Adriano Moraes. This is Mike Lee.
Give me just a second, so I can catch my breath. It's a face-to-face with my humanity. I spent my share of time pretending that I knew all of the answers. But answers without truth, just a blind lead, a blind away from you. Why are we so convinced that we were the fan to show the
I don't like to be comfortable. I like to live radically. I'm just not kind of the normal person. I like to just step out there and walk on the edge, you know.
When you look at the top guys, the reason that they're in the top five is they can ride the ranked bulls. Mike Lee can ride any bull at any given time. The harder they buck, the better he rides.
If you think you're going to fight bulls or ride bulls for a living, and you're going to come out of this thing as pretty as you started, you know, and then for guys like me, I didn't start out pretty anyway, so, you know, it's just not going to happen. You're going to end up with scars.
They see some wrecks. Guys that get bucked off and thrown halfway across the arena or get run over. And that's what they go for. They don't go to see somebody get killed, but if they do, they don't want to miss it. And I suppose that's the human way.
My job is when we first start trying to describe it and everybody goes, oh, you're a rodeo clown. No, I'm not a rodeo clown. I'm not funny. You know, they don't hire me because of my jokes. My job is more like I'm a bodyguard. My job is to make sure that when they hit the ground, that I'm the one that steps in there and we make sure we draw the animal to us for those guys to get away safely. We take a lot of pride. If somebody's supposed to take the shot, it's supposed to be us. The nights where we really do a good job is when the nights that you don't even notice we're there. And then sometimes it doesn't work right. You know, there's good nights at the office, and then there's those nights where certain guys' riding styles don't suit the way certain bulls buck. And it's a bad night at the office. Ideally for us, if they get thrown off from the shoulder of the bull back, we should be able to get there. Because the bull's got to bend and get back around to get to him. It's our job to be in between. And sometimes there's 6 foot, and sometimes there's 3 foot, and sometimes there's inches. But when they get thrown from the shoulder forward, where that bull doesn't have to change direction to get there, it's pretty tough for my 2 legs to beat those 4 legs to get to him. It's a dangerous sport. It's unforgiving. The bull doesn't listen to the whistle. The bull doesn't listen to anybody hollering time out. The bull determines when the game's over. And it just depends on how bad he wants to play the game on that particular night.
I grew up on a ranch and got introduced to the sport at a real young age. My grandpa had ridden bulls, my dad had ridden bulls. I started getting on little calves and things when I was 3-4 years old and had a lot of fun doing it. And the older I got, I just kept doing it. And at such an early age, I knew exactly what I wanted to do. So, you know, trying to get me to read Romeo and Juliet when I was 14, really didn't apply to me much, I didn't think, you know. Well, my grandpa was actually killed while riding a bull, but it was before I was born. It wasn't something that affected me or had some sort of impact on me as a child. That is part of bull riding. It's unlike any other sport, I guess. You're not competing against another human, you are competing against a wild animal. But it's not something I would want to do and have a family of my own. It's a little raw, and it can be life-threatening, it can be dangerous, it can be fun, it can be exciting.
Already 4 wins this season at Phoenix, Greensboro, Indianapolis, and also Tacoma. Justin's gotten 11 top 10 finishes. This is what guys call a stellar year.
Hey, guys. Hey, 15 minutes, it's going to be pouring down rain. If I were you, I'd take your rigging bags and go underneath behind the bucking chutes. Because in 15 minutes, it's going to rain, and rain hard.
I travel with these guys day in and day out for 28 weekends a year, every weekend for 4 months straight. Getting there on Thursdays, leaving on Sundays, watching them every weekend. I watch the rituals that they get into, and it changes ever so slightly. Whether or not they're focusing, they stick by themselves. Sometimes they're more playful. I watch the ebb and flow of how they're dealing with their injuries, the fear, possibly, of a certain animal.
No, we are a big family, a bunch of friends and brothers. And I think that's another reason that we try to help each other. Because imagine if I get in an argue with somebody, or if I'm really compete against that person and I have to be with that person all year round, you know, my life is gonna be miserable. But if I am his friend and I helping, he helps me, that environment is totally different.
I'm not really scared of dying that much no more, you know? Now that I found the truth, when I nod my head, I know that if I die on this bull, then I'm gonna go to heaven and see my Lord, and that'd be the happiest day of my life. I just trust the Lord so much that he blesses me because of that, you know. Praying on my knees and humbling yourself before men is like stepping out in a stadium and saying, hey, I'm a Christian, you know.
I think probably there was a time when being a Christian was looked on as almost like being a sissy or something. Something that a lot of guys didn't talk about. If you was a real cowboy, the image was that you didn't need no help from nobody.
Fear does not dwell in me before I ride. People view our sport a lot of times and they say, boy, you guys, there must be such an adrenaline rush. And they view our sport like skydiving. They think we get all geared up and then we, boom, we jump out of the plane. Nothing further from that. It's like standing over home plate in the bottom of the ninth inning when there's the full count and there's a runner on third.
Your breath quickens and your heart rate speeds up. You have to have amazing brain control and be an unbelievable athlete to be able to do that flawlessly when you're talking about something that is not so much just a matter of winning or losing, but maybe living or dying. From the athlete's perspective, that changes everything.
The term being hung up is your hand is stuck in your rope and it won't come out. If I'm left-handed, I always want to exit to the left side, and the reason is when I open my hand, the handle is usually about that long, and my hand will just slide down the rope and come out. The problem is if I come off of the right side, then if my hand turns over, then it wedges and locks your hand in the rope.
If I could one time have an opportunity to get the attention of Dr. Tandy Freeman, I can tell you how many concussions Rob Bell's had. 3 concussions. Now, this is a guy that's been advised by the medical staff, you need to wear a helmet. He refuses to do it. He says it throws off his balance. It's not his style.
These guys, they have a different perception of pain. Injury's part of the sport. It's not if you're going to get hurt, it's when and how bad.
You can get paralyzed, you can get killed, but we block that. We don't ever think about that. We don't. Even when a guy before you gets killed, because it happens before, you see your best friend get killed right there, or get hurt, or breaking a leg, or breaking a neck, or whatever it is, and right away you block that. I'm scared all the time. I'm not scared of getting hurt, that's a part of the business, but scared of fail. That's devastating. That's devastating.
Open your eyes for me. Watch my finger.
Yeah.
Double vision or no?
No, just
blurry. No. I know it's blurry. But
blurry. Yeah.
Okay. How about over here?
I can't. It hurts.
It hurts. Okay. How about down here?
It hurts a little.
Okay. You're gonna need some surgery.
Yeah. I know. How long?
How long?
Until I ride.
Yeah, you'll be able to ride Reno for sure. You don't need to ride before then.
It hurts.
Everybody out here doesn't need to be here. Let's go. Now. Come on. Let's go. Please, you guys. Come on.
Horn caught him right on the corner of his cheek and fractured the cheek. When you fix these guys, they're going back out there. And there's a chance that a guy may end up being re-injured. I'm suggesting to Adriano that he wear a helmet, and I think he's going to take that suggestion to heart. It certainly would be unwise to go back out there without a helmet.
It made me realize that life is more than just the arena, just bull riding. Who am I? And who am I going to live with? Adriano Moraes, a man, a Christian, a husband, a dad, or Adriano Moraes, an ex-bull rider that had to quit because couldn't do it no more. I think I am Adriano Moraes, the farmer that was chosen to be a good rider. And Adriano Moraes, the farmer, is going to have to survive after the Adriano Moraes, the rider, is gone, because it will come to an end someday. I'm not going to quit now because I still have to accomplish a lot. And I'm not done, and I won't be done until the day I quit.
Father, I thank you for your presence here today. I thank you for the people that were able to get here to overcome adversity, because I know that there's things that stood in their path of coming here.
You've heard there's no such thing as an atheist in a foxhole. I think this is the truth that we see in a sport such as bull riding. You're dealing with people that have to literally stare at death in the face every time they compete. It's something that I love to see in men. The desire to be able to overcome the fear and the unknown and be willing to risk whatever it is for the sake of a prize.
It's been my life. I loved them even when we made no money out of them. I love them. I even hate to sell one. It hurts me more than anything to sell one of the young ones that's upcoming that you think has that opportunity. This is Mossy Oak Mudslinger. He's our favorite. One of the greatest bucking bulls ever. He blows way high in the air and drops and kicks over his head and spins in the gate and just challenges them to ride.
I've been on Mudslinger several times. The times I've ridden him, it was the most fun thing in the world. Such a hard sport to explain to somebody. because, you know, there's not really a lot of logic in going and getting on a 2,000-pound bull and trying to ride him with one hand for 8 seconds. But when you ride a great bull like Mudslinger and you experience the feeling, the adrenaline rush, the, you know, just how good you feel after making a great ride, when 15,000 people are cheering for you and, you know, your buddies are high-fiving you, and it's just a great feeling.
The judges say 90.5.
That brings him to a $229,000 season so far.
As far as telling which bull's gonna buck, it has a lot to do with their personality, I'd say. You know, I don't know if a lot of people even knows that, you know, animal athletes have a personality. A world champion basketball player, anything else, any athlete, they have to have a big heart and really love what they do to excel at it. And I think that goes along the same lines with bucking bulls. They have to really love their job.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest bovine athletes in the world today, seldom ridden, a champ in the arena, this is Little Yellow Jacket.
For the people that think that these bulls are injured, the bull is way too valuable to this sport to injure him. You have bulls like Little Yellow Jacket that are worth over $150,000. You can't spend that kind of money on something and abuse it. The prime deal that they always try to say is the flank rope is put around the bull's testicles. If you stop and think about it, and any man would definitely know this, if something has you by your private parts and is squeezing on it tightly, the last thing you're going to do is jump and kick. You're going to stand really still. You know? I mean, that's it.
Do you know how many times I hear somebody and they're like, they tie their balls together. That's just horrible. Well, no, they don't tie their balls together. And if you watch a bull riding, you can see them babies swinging.
In 3, 2, 1, go ahead.
Mike White.
Well, a little more conviction.
Don't stop him now, he's on a roll.
Mike White.
Yes.
Now there's conviction
for
you.
Wanna
put you like right over here?
And
are we happy? Are we mad?
I think it's game face.
Ladies and gentlemen, Adriano is back. He's healthy, and he's riding here tonight.
I don't like the helmet. I'm not against it, but for me, I don't think it's going to help. It's too much weight that I'm not used to it, and I'm going to have too much whiplash that I take the risk for now.
With Adriano's injury, another little tap right now without a helmet. The bone's not going to be healed. Means you're starting all over, and it might actually increase the severity of the injury.
Yes, Adriano is still your leader. He's out for 2 weeks and comes back to dominate Red Thunder.
When we look back on the sport in 30 years, you'll say, you remember the days when Adriano Marias rode? Because he's that Wayne Gretzky or that Michael Jordan of the sport. If he wins his third world title, you're going to hear a lot of people say he's probably the greatest bull rider ever.
They're gamblers. They're also tough guys. And to some degree, wearing a helmet, it admits a certain amount of either fear or defeat.
Competition-wise, no one's out to win second. Everybody's out to win first.
Everybody says they don't do it because of the money. They do it because they love riding bulls. Adam and I, we do it because we do love riding bulls, but also because of the money. That's what made Adam and I. That's pretty much our career. That's what we know.
I know that this weekend I could be rich again, you know? I might be struggling now, but you wouldn't know that next weekend, you know, when you see me in Laughlin, because I'm gonna win about 30,000. And I got two kids, and I know that by riding bulls, I'm making a living for them two kids. I want to give them twice what I've had.
The only thing bull riders want to do is to ride that bull, get down the road, put some money in his pocket, and have 140 acres, a couple of good horses, and a pretty woman.
Yours, right on the butt.
There you go.
Here's Hal Grillo, one of the twin brothers, the veteran now in Dublin, Texas. He's got a bull called Camo. Oh, that is a head-on collision with that bull.
There are a lot of extreme sports where people may die, but they're not guaranteed to get hurt as long as everything goes like it's supposed to. Everything can go like the way it's supposed to when you're riding a bull and you still end up being hurt.
Look up here for me. Watch my finger with your eyes. Tell me if you have any blurred vision or double vision.
Yeah, kind of, just a little bit.
How about now?
If I close it, I don't. Might be just because he hit me, huh?
No.
Right there.
Feel that click?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep, it's broke.
I'll be ready for the finals, huh?
You'll be fine for getting on at the finals, okay?
I got knocked out, I don't know how many times. They hadn't invented concussions then, you know. When you got knocked out, well, they poured water on you and drug you out of the arena. We had old Jack Daniels, and so if you're crippled, you go have a drink, and nobody sympathized with you very much. And you didn't have any of the healers. You just did what you had to do and went on.
He could have broke my jaw or end up throwing me underneath him and stepping on me and breaking an arm or a leg. You know, it could have been a lot worse, a whole lot worse, but you know what? This is a dangerous sport. Makes me upset because I see him like this and I've been in that situation. You know, to see my own brother hurt or even fail, that's the worst thing about riding bulls. And tonight, I'm embarrassed. Adam's embarrassed. You know, it hurts us to get bucked off to fail. And we hate failing.
What you can see is down here on the bottom part on the right, this piece of bone kind of ends. That's because that's the break higher up here where it's pushed down and away. If you think that helmets would be ubiquitous in bull riding, you don't know bull riders. That's changing. As more of the younger guys come on, we'll see more guys wearing helmets.
I don't think the helmet's gonna really hinder me. We'll have to see. It's just something I've never done before.
See Bucket Daddy? Do good. Call me when you get there.
Okay, honey. What does Mom think? She wants me to wear the helmet, of course, and I'm going to. Of course, you know, she's real scared. I got on the bucket machine, I felt really dizzy with it. Riding, looking down, it's like my equilibrium wasn't all there, right? And he took a pretty good blow, he got a concussion. A lot of guys, so-called old school, say, oh, that's not cowboy, that's not cowboy. Well, what's cowboy? You know, sure, cowboy's being tough, but I mean, you got a smart cowboy and you got dumb cowboys. And the smart cowboys are the ones that are going to take care of themselves, you know, do things that are right for them and prolong their career. A lot of guys all cowboy up, got a cowboy this. And they end up getting hurt, well, then their career's done.
Halfway between the bull rider and the bull. An essential piece of equipment.
My dad, through the help of some old rope makers, he learned how to make the bull rope, and then he passed it on to my brother and myself. It's the one piece of equipment that you really do have to have. The bull rope, a pair of spurs, plus good sticky rosin, which is just a no-slip factor. Even though most of the bull riders only weigh, 155 pounds, when they're maxed out and the bull gets their chin up and goes to straightening their arm, they just need all the gripping power and the holding power that they can get. Your puller hands you the rope,
in the chute. Bring your slack up around behind, pull it tight. Whether you split your finger off, which allows you to close your little finger and give you more gripping power. When the bull rider pounds his hand to make that hand feel locked, he's telling that hand to stay shut. I think you basically ride bulls with your fingers. You really can't ride them with your hand. It sets you down on your butt too much and holds your wrist down. Your wrist has to be in a turned up position for you to get your pelvic area up against it. We call it cracking your seat. When the bull runs him off his rope a little bit, you see him making tremendous moves and effort to get his hip area right back up on that rope. That's their safety zone. And that's the peaceful place to be. Even though quite a few numbers are coming into the game, the great ones only show up ever so often.
After winning 3 world titles, you look to the highest level, and that was Bodacious. Bodacious was probably the most dangerous bull that I ever saw or got on. He was already starting to get a little bit of a reputation of what they call jerk guys down. When he hits the ground, it pulls you down forward and smashes you right in the face, which is not good. So that makes me want to ride him more. And then I finally drew him. I nod, and first jump, everything's fine. The next jump, I just, this big whack. And next thing I know, I'm laying on the ground, and didn't really knock me out, just kind of stunned me a little bit. I get up, and I'm bleeding like a stuck hog. The farther I walk, the reaction I'm getting just by, they're looking at me like they just saw Frankenstein. From here to here is just shattered, just mush. They put in, I don't know, probably 5 titanium plates, all kinds of screws. And I'm in the hospital a little bit over a week, but I get home and my oldest son, he's a little boy. He says, "Dad, if you ever draw Bodacious again, you're gonna have to chicken out." I said, "Okay." Had they said, "You know, we'll give you $1 million to get on this bull," I wouldn't have got on him because I wasn't gonna risk getting killed. You know, he was simply that dangerous.
And the way I ride is a lot different from the way Adriano rides. And when I ride, it's more balanced. Well, Adriano's got arms bigger than both of my legs put together. So, you know, when he rides, he uses a lot of strength. You know, he really clamps down tight to the bull.
What this man's been accomplishing this year is astounding. He can break all the records.
It's a no score.
I don't think it's the bull's fault, it's my fault. You know, I'm giving up lately. I'm not happy with my riding. You know, I should be a little more tough, you know, and hold on a little longer because I lost a lot of money and a lot of points because of my giving up.
Big, big part of riding bulls is knowing that you can ride them. When doubt creeps in, it's really hard to stay on.
Is Adriano losing his focus? Now it's not just mental, but it's physical. We've asked all year long, as good a season as he's having, 3 wins, 14 top tens, will his body at 34 years old be able to hold up?
In this business, if you relax a little bit, you just go down, and you can't imagine how far down you go, and it's hard to come back. And that's what I'm trying to do, rise up to the top again.
Mike Lee, I think he's ahead of his game. He's ahead of everybody's game. That's the most talented guy we have, and he's overdoing it now. He just needs to realize why he rides and how he rides and slow down.
That hurt? Yeah. Sorry. Tender back.
That's sore back there.
Yeah. I think dorsal cartilage in your shoulder. I don't think that, I think that's what that pop is.
What's up? Just a little weak.
Growing up on the ranch kind of gives you a sense of humbleness. You don't whine, you don't cry, you get your work done, and you go to bed and you get up in the morning. It's simple, you know. You just don't complain about them things, and you just learn to deal with them.
Mike sustained a fairly significant injury to his shoulder. It's his riding arm. If it had been his free arm, it might have been a different story as to whether he would have been able to go back out and ride again this evening.
I'm back here walking out with Mike Lee. His left shoulder, which is the opposite shoulder from what he usually
is. These guys ride with a lot of injuries that in other situations, people would probably go ahead and have something done right away. If he were playing the NBA, playing in Major League Baseball, this is an injury that he might not be able to compete with.
Mike Lee is getting on his second bull tonight with a dislocated shoulder.
Where you are in relation to Adriano, where McBride is, and you say you're taking it jump by jump. How do you shut out everything else?
When I nod my head, I'm gonna be ready to die that day, and that's the way I want to ride. You can't worry about anything else, but you just gotta be that free. You gotta be ready to die, and just that's the way I look at it.
That's the good stuff there, baby. Homemade rosin. Everybody likes it, they want it. Best stuff there is. Your hand won't come out, it's staying there longer than you want it to.
Behold, all things are become new. Forget about that old ride and that old bowls you did. You got a new one today. All things, it says here, have become new. You can't worry about what happened yesterday. You got to be concerned about the bull you're going to ride today, what's going to happen tonight. Father, in the name of Jesus, he knows that you all want the top bull, but I'm believing God for every bull that you've gone tonight to be that top bull. Jesus, you are the way, the truth, and the life, and we seek that this night in this ride, claiming victory, victory, victory this night in Jesus' glorious and wonderful name.
I hold my breath in this sport every single day, because death is inevitable, and I just pray that it's not gonna happen sooner rather than later. But it will happen. We've got great cowboy athletes, but we'll have bulls, and some of them are mean, and some of them wanna hurt you. And even beyond that, bull's not gauging his strength. He's not saying, oh, I'm just gonna hurt him a little bit. They're in there doing their thing.
Stepped on right in the middle of his back. And you see that protective vest that he has on? It's designed to take the shock and the impact out of these guys when they're stepped on. Right now, we're hoping and praying it's did its job. We'll get an update as soon as we can, let you know the status of Jody Newberry.
The thing about our sport is there are no backups. You know, no backups where you get paid. The backup gets paid. You know, and if you're going to put food on your table, this sport here, you better know how to cowboy up.
Next week may be questionable.
Okay.
How are you sitting?
I'm broken. Yeah. I sent you no money.
Fire.
Paying for their medical bills. If you're not married with a wife who's on an insurance plan, these guys do have a tough time of it. Guys gamble not only with their lives, but they gamble with their financial stability.
The guys who don't make it were potentially just as good as Tuff and Adriano. Whether it was just a bad, bad broken leg, a wrecked hand that calls him, you feel for them and you never forget them. And I have so many of those on my list that are, you know, still in my heart. You know, I still wonder where they are, whether he's in Idaho or Florida.
I like to win money. That's awesome because I get to make a living riding bulls. I don't have to go get a job. But that's not the reason I do it. I could win $10 million in cards, and I'd still have all the motivation in the world to go get on tonight. Well, this season, I've rode some I probably shouldn't have, and I fell off some that I probably should have rode. In Grand Rapids, Michigan, got on a bull called Lefty. I think if you count all the times up, I still haven't ridden him 8 seconds. Lefty just took one or two long jumps and was turning to the left and just threw me off. Not a wreck of any sort. We wanted to put our foot in the same place.
Does it hurt right here where I'm pushing?
Not bad, a little bit.
A little bit. That hurt when I do that?
It's all right.
Yeah, it's broken right here. You want to feel it?
Uh-uh.
Okay. And it's broken right up here. Both bones.
What? Yeah. I ain't got but one leg bone.
It's getting cleaned up.
Very, very seldom do you get a guy who loses it when he's hurt. There is a certain cultural element to it. It's the cowboy up sort of attitude that if you're hurt, you just deal with it and go on about your business. To get to the level that these guys are competing at, you have to have already dealt with injury. You have to have gone through this, and it's a process of natural selection. Wimps just don't make it that far along.
This is the third time he's been in contention for the world championship, and he's gotten injured near the end of the year.
Well, I've just got done talking to Dr. Tandy Freeman, and yes, I'm sorry to report that Justin did break his ankle in two places, and he's going to have surgery. He won't be riding tomorrow night, and the status of whether he'll be able to ride at the finals is still to be determined. But right now, Justin is not a happy man.
But Just McBride got hurt. It hurts me too, because I put myself on his situation. So I'm not competing against him. I gotta compete against myself. I gotta beat me every single time. I gotta be better than I was yesterday and worse than I'm gonna be tomorrow. You know, and that's the way I am. Just McBride, he's not trying to beat Adrian Moraes. He's trying to pass the guy that's leading that happens to be me.
Well, no surprises. What we're gonna do is make an incision over here on this side of the ankle. two screws across that to hold it in place. Go over here, make an incision, push the two bones closer together like they're supposed to be, put a screw across, and I'll look at this area up here. We'll probably end up with a plate running down here with that screw going through, and that's about it. Everything else is pretty much like you and I talked about.
I assumed my year's over. There goes not only next weekend, but there goes the World Finals also. Tandy Freeman's a little different than most doctors, I think. You know, without him, we wouldn't be able to do it.
Clamp, cut.
You know, he understands what we do and how passionate we are about it. He's gonna do everything he can to make sure that we can compete. You know, I'm sure if I'd have went to a normal doctor, I would have still been sitting at home right now. There's been a few times now where he has saved my whole season. If it's something that's broken, he'll fix it to where it can't be broken any worse. If you can deal with it, you can go.
You know, the injuries that I faced, seeing some of my best friends die in front of my eyes, you know, it makes no sense at all. And I've got two sons that I hope like hell that they don't do it. But for me, it's the only thing that I wanted to do. And if I was healthy enough, if I felt like I was healthy enough and in good enough shape today, I'd be riding today. You do have three guys that have a legitimate chance to win the world title. And when you look down the list, you see Adriano Moraes in first, and he's got to be the odds-on favorite. You know, he's been there and done that. He's won it a few times. He's been beat up a little bit, but all the guys are beat up.
It's up to me if I win or lose. It's not up to Justin, to Mike Lee. You know, it's up to me. If I'm not riding my best, if I'm not trying my best, it's my fault, and I gotta rely on my performance, not on their performance. How well am I riding? That's why I gotta worry about it.
Hey man, see you in Vegas.
These men are chasing titles. They're chasing that dream to say, I'm the world champion, and to sit at their kitchen table with their family. And, you know, these are a lot of guys that live in little small podunk places. And when they walk down the street, it's like the old timers, like, hey, how'd you do this weekend? For these men, it's about $1 million on the line, and it's about being able to walk home with the title.
Welcome to the PBR Finals in Las Vegas. For two weekends, we have 45 riders competing for the race for the world title. The world champion goes home with $1 million in his pocket. It'll be handed out right here in Las Vegas. You want to talk about pressure? It's all in Las Vegas. Adriano Moraes, the two-time world champion, comes to the World Finals with a commanding point lead, over 2,000 points, but there are men chasing close and they're near. The other thing is all the bonus points up for grabs, 2,500 of them. To the winner of this thing, a lot of points are going to be tallied up here. The world championship race is going to come down to the wire.
That's perfect. Enough airflow, nothing.
Yeah, and even just a little more water in, just to make sure, but that should be fine.
Yep, I'm gonna announce your name, then walk out.
Okay. Yeah. What's in the trophy to drink?
Just that.
Here's the wild man, Tony Mendez, Adam Carrillo, Wiley Peterson, Oklahoma's Justin McBride, Paradise, Texas, and Mike Lee. This is Adriano.
Father, thank you for this privilege, and we just come together tonight, Lord, as Americans. We want to ask you, Lord, to continue to bless and protect our troops as they're fighting for this very freedom.
These are the men of the United States Armed Forces, the protectors of freedom. I know you're proud to be Americans tonight. This is our flag of the United States of America.
The one and only question we have from this arena floor is, Las Vegas, are you ready on a Friday night?
This man's doing something heroic. Just 3 weeks ago, he broke his leg in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And Dr. Tandy Freeman went in, put a plate over and some screws in over the top of that fracture to hold that leg together.
Where I'm at right now, my leg concerns me zero. And I know it can't be hurt any worse by riding. Tandy fixed it, and that's it. It's not a big deal. I want to ride eight bulls.
Justin McBride wants to win.
Unbelievable. This man is amazing. I say it again. That's unbelievable.
Adriano knows what it's like to compete a whole year and to put a lifetime into something and then have an injury be what stops you.
This is the man they're all chasing, the Brazilian, Adriano Moraes. Two world championships already in his pocket and now reaching down deep to go for a third. The man's got his family here with him, but there's one thing about this sport. In this game, every bull rider's out here in this arena on his own.
This could be a bicep injury. I've seen guys tear their bicep loose, and I'm not saying that's what happened, but that's sure what it looks like the way he's holding it walking out of the ring.
Hurt right here? Hurt down here?
No.
Okay. It hurts right there, right?
Yeah, right. See?
Yeah. Okay. See this? Okay. You pulled it off the bone.
Yeah, he did.
Adriano tore the biceps tendon loose from the elbow on his riding arm. He wears a brace on that elbow. And keeping that brace on is going to be a problem because the biceps tendon is so sore.
Hey, good job.
Good job. We'll be right back.
Texas, the number two man chasing Adriano Moraes.
Mike's going to be the one to watch. You know, if I'm Adriano, that right there is just competition. This guy's focused, and I think he really wants it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You go nuts.
They've actually taped him over the top of the brace. His arm's so sore that it hurts too much to put the tape on under the brace. Tonight's going to be really telling for Adriano. It's easy to sit back and say, yeah, you'll get out the pain. But, you know, when you're trying to ride these caliber of bulls, it's hard enough when you're 100% healthy.
My mind, my spirit is pretty strong right now. But I don't know if my body will hold up. And my body's going to determine if I win or lose.
Sign you could look for. It's like he had both arms tied behind his back. You know, that's too bad, but I'm still not going to count the guy out.
Is it?
Saturday.
What was the bull you had tonight?
Shallow.
Okay. Who are you staying with?
Just me.
Somebody needs to stay with him tonight or else you're going to have to ship him to the hospital for a CAT scan.
Dave, you stay with me.
Okay. You've got my numbers, and if there's any problem at all, anything, you call me.
Adam, are you going to stay with him?
They're going to get you in.
Stay with us, man.
And we've been waiting all year long to do what we are about to do in Las Vegas on Sunday afternoon. Are you ready?
I just trust the Lord so much. I'm not worried about going to hell. That's what really drives my life, is fighting this world off. And for a bull rider, that's extremely hard, because you got beer, you got women, and there's all kinds of temptations for a bull rider at this stage.
Adriano Moraes. He's bucked off twice, lasting only 1 second in round three. The injured arm has been the factor here. His title hopes are in jeopardy if he does not ride this bull right now. Thank you.
awful lot about the size of this man's heart, Adriano. So many men thought that you couldn't hang on to Crossfire Hurricane. Describe that 93-point ride.
I had one of the best pulls out, so I had to bear down, endure the pain, and praise God I was able to do and make a 93-point ride.
Better, apparently. Well,
after the first three rounds, looked like Adriano was too injured and not going to be able to ride a bull the rest of the week. He comes back, rides Crossfire Hurricane, who's, you know, one of the baddest bulls in the PBR, and he rides him, and a couple of the other guys are bucked off, and it changes from go round to go round, and it's a long ways from over. But I think you have to look as Adriano as the favorite. You can't count him out.
Beside your neck?
My back.
Your back where?
Right in the middle.
Right in the middle? Okay. Tell me, what day of the week is it?
I don't know.
Okay. Good enough.
This is a sport that can kill you in a heartbeat. Are you crazy? Are you nuts? You must be. And I know that it must look like that, and I've spent a lifetime trying to defend and explain why somebody would do that. But to me, it probably sounds really crazy, but I think that's the reason guys do it, and I think that's the reason people pay to watch us do it.
Let's get him up. We got four people on three. One, two, three, up. Let's go out that way. Feet first.
I love the sport, and I've had a lot of people ask me why, especially after the couple of broken necks. People would say, well, how could you keep fighting bulls? And I'd say, well, you know, God's got a plan for me. I don't know what it is, but sooner or later, he'll show it to me. When God picks your time, he picks your time.
Corey, I'll get the helmet off when we get in the training room, okay? Corey's awake. He's moving all of his extremities. There's some things we can't do here at the arena to check that out, so he's been sent to the hospital to make sure everything's okay.
Justin is the kind of guy that rides 90% with balance, but because of his leg, he's not able to balance as well, so he's relying on his strength. That's devastating.
Four bulls this week. We have got to help this man to his feet and out of this arena tonight. You need to get on your feet, Las Vegas! This will be my claim, Paradise, Texas.
Between you and this bull, right? That's all it's about.
This is going to be a test for Mike Lee. You know, this is why it's the PBR Finals. This is why it's the World Championship. This is why it's the epitome of bull riding right here.
There's still a man yet to go, and that being Adriano.
He can ride any bull in the world. It's just going to be a matter of how his arm holds up and how he holds up. There's a ton of pressure on the guy right now.
Hey, dude, he's back.
You're talking about a sport that is so dangerous that you have to learn how to compartmentalize the fear and the danger and the pressures and the press and the bright lights and stay focused on your ride, because the bulls, they don't get none of that.
Adrian, back inside the box.
You
squatting in the box. You had to take him wide.
No, I was very scared there, because I've seen that calf bucking before, and you know, it's kind of hard and a lot of pressure, and I don't think I was gonna nod. And Mike Lee came up to me and said, "Nod your head, you can ride him." And you know, if you say so, I believe I can. Sorry, I took a little while, but you know.
Get. Don't care about that. Care about the fact that you are now one step closer to an unprecedented third world title.
Thanks, Mike Lee, that he went up to me and said, "Nod your head, you can ride me." I was
Thanks, bro.
There's four or five guys that are doing extremely well here at the finals. They want to win so bad, they have several other chances, and they can handle the pressure, because they've never been pressured much. I've been under pressure for 15 years. The only pressure that I want, the only one that I can handle, is riding my bulls. And if I do it well, I may win. If not, I may lose.
Thank you.
little bit more scared. You turn the fear into your aggression, or you just go at it. The word I'd use is abandon.
This is it. Adriano Moraes on the back of a bull that's never been ridden. They call him Big Bucks. And if he rides him, it can be worth just that. $1 million in a third world championship. This is Adriano Moraes.
I tip my hat to him, a young champion. He's gonna win many, many more world titles, and he's the man. He tried his guts out, his faith, his love for this sport, and it pays back. I slipped, he did not. He's the man, and congratulations to him, but I'm not done. I'll be back.
Yeah, couple weeks. Back at it again.
That's for the troops overseas right now. I just give you thanks for letting us be free. And just, that's what God's about. God give us a country that we can be free in. Thank you. See you guys overseas.
Well, phenomenal young man.
You've been in the Army and you've been through service. I mean, you're just humbled. You're a humble person because you know what the reward's about. To make them smile is, you know, that's awesome to me. And it was nice to have them there.